In just a moment, I'm going to introduce a musician to you, someone from here in our own neighborhood that you may already know. He's one of three musicians from the ensemble Kirkmount. His brothers Simon and Sam play cello and violin, but our guest for this hour is Alex Bigney on the Celtic harp. Hi, I'm Fauneil Purcell. It's my pleasure to welcome you to Highway 89. Highway 89 is Utah's most scenic musical byway with a new destination every week. Tonight we have with us the harpist from the Celtic group Kirkmount, Alex Bigney. Alex, thanks for coming to play with us.
Hi, Fauneil. Great to be here with you this evening.
How long ago did your family live in Scotland? Trace us a little bit from here in Provo back to Scotland.
Actually, it's been a long time since Scotland. But my grandfather and his family lived mostly in Boston, but he grew up in the small town of Kirkmount. I believe you mentioned before here, the name of the group that I've played with is Kirkmount. That's Gaelic for Church Hill, Church Mountain. And that's where he grew up in Nova Scotia, which is, again, New Scotland. His family had come from the British Isles, and it's been a few generations away, but we still feel it hot in our blood.
And that was your grandfather?
That was my grandfather, and we called him Bud.
So if you go on Highway 89, just up north, through Montana, Glacier National Park, then you hang right.
Beautiful area.
You go about 3,000 miles, you get to Nova Scotia.
That's right.
And have you been to Nova Scotia?
I have. It's beautiful out there. Cape Breton Island, we've been up there and played some music up there. Wonderful music, of course.
And you've actually gone and visited Kirkmount.
We have, yeah. And we played at a few different venues while we were out there. But my brother played on the gravesite of family members. He played over the gravesite with his fiddle. And I believe that I brought my bones along.
Tell us what bones are.
Let me grab them here just a second.
Okay, grab your bones there.
The bones are the predecessor to the spoons. They're an ancient percussion instrument. Usually they are two rib bones or two bones that can be clacked together in your hand. The way that my grandpa taught us, he said, it's all in the wrist. He, of course, showed us how to hold them in our fingers. And the basic rhythm that he gave us was diddly-ump. Right. And that's what he always said, diddly-ump. If you can do that, then you can play along with any type of the Scottish music. So there's your diddly-ump.
Uh-huh. You have to tap your toes when you listen to that.
Yeah, gets your toes tapping.
It does. We've heard the percussive bones. What can you play for us now?
The Celtic music really, well, and this is probably true of all genres of music that I'm familiar with, it tells a story. This is a song that I actually wrote for my old harp that I had. We went through a house fire. Only musicians could probably understand how hard it would be to lose the instrument that you had played on for so long. When I found out that the house was on fire, I came zooming back from my work and saw the smoke billowing out. And the first thought after I found out my family was okay, you know, thinking of the things that are in the house is, where's my harp?
Right.
And I panicked. And the thought crossed my head, although rather foolish, that I might go in the house that was burning after the harp. You know, maybe I could save it, but luckily there were firefighters there. No, you're not going in.
So this is a new harp you're playing.
So this is a new harp for me, but I did write this tune for the old one. I named it Lament for a Friend, and I think it's somewhat a universal idea or a universal story that many people can relate to.
Okay, so we'll hear Alex Bigney playing Lament for a Friend on the Celtic harp.
Thank you.
Alex Bigney in the studio with us on Highway 89. Alex, thank you so much for being here.
It's been a pleasure.
Really enjoyed this. It's been wonderful learning about the harp, learning more about your group, Kirkmount. I know I'm going to be seeking you out in the future, maybe at a venue where I can jump up and do some jigging as I listen to you
play.
Thank
you very much.
Thank you so much for being here. And thanks for joining us again on Highway 89. Our guest has been Alex Bigney from the Celtic Ensemble Kirkmount.